10 years ago, I was filing more stories on La Cosa Nostra and organized crime here than I am now, although I feel like after the Salemi trial and a couple of other things, it's ramped up a little bit. I'd love to hear from you your assessment of New England La Cosa Nostra right now.
Sure. So that the LCN subject, just writ large, you know, as you know, is a significant part of my background. I worked it for many years against the Bonanno organized crime family out of the New York office at a time when LCN was still one of the FBI's top priorities. When I look at LCN, and it's not just New England, it's the LCN throughout the country. When you look at what the Bureau has done over the course of decades, utilizing the RICO statute, the enterprise theory of investigation, we've done a very effective job at significantly disrupting the stranglehold that the LCN has had on a multitude of different industries. It does not mean that it is currently not a threat anymore, but it is not a threat at the level of some of the threats that we've already talked about and that we've been, or that we will talk about this afternoon as well. But one thing I would like to say about LCN is, you mentioned the Salemi case. That's a classic example where we still have investigators that are devoted throughout our division to investigating LCN. And at the end of the day, that's a classic example of a cold case homicide or a significant situation that occurred where you have a victim's family or families out there that never received any closure. And anytime we ever receive any intelligence or information, whether it be from informants or a member of the public or a historical case where something comes to light after many years, we will aggressively continue to follow up on those matters to work the threat.